What's up, guys? Eric Rivera here, Fitness Phenom, coming to you guys with another calisthenics wad. This one, it's a little different. So usually I do things for time. This one was an AMRAP, right? So my CrossFit athletes, you guys already know what AMRAP stands for my calisthenics peeps. AMRAP means as many rounds as possible, as many reps as possible. I did a 20 minute AMRAP. So obviously the workouts basically was a 20 minute circuit, three movements, 5 pull-ups, 10 dips, 15 push-ups. So you got your big three in calisthenics, your pull-ups, your dips, and your push-ups. Right. As always, full range of motion on those movements, all the way down and up. You guys know the deal, full extension. It recruits the most muscle fibers. It's going to get you stronger. So give this a go if you have that capacity. If not, scale down the time. If 20 minutes is a lot, go down to 15, go down to 12, go down to 10 minutes, whatever you got. If 5, 10, 15 reps is a lot, scale down the reps, right? If you gotta go 3 pull-ups, 5 dips, 10 push-ups, go 3, 5, 10. If you gotta go 1, 3, 5, go 1, 3, 5. 1 pull-up, 3 dips, 5 push-ups. Whatever you have to do to keep it sustainable and work on your muscular endurance. And depending on how fast you're going, work on that cardiovascular endurance as well. So check it out. I won't say how many rounds I got. I'll let you guys do the math, or you can watch the end of the video. Make sure you guys like and subscribe. Follow me on the gram, FitnessPhenom21. I'm always posting free workouts. Let's level up. Let's get it. Make sure to work full range of motion on all exercises. Make sure you guys are locking out for all three movements. 15 push-ups. So if you're looking to work or increase your work capacity, this is something you want to give a try. Get as many rounds as you can in 20 minutes. As many reps as you can.
You have the ability to go unbroken. All your movements, go unbroken. You gotta break it up, break it up. You gotta scale down on your reps, meaning if you gotta do less than the 5x10x15, scale down, but stick with that number throughout the entire 20 minutes. 20 minutes is a lot. Scale down the time. Down to 15. Down to 10, whatever you got. Round number 4 coming up. Working the big three in calisthenics: pull-ups, dips, and push-ups. Full work in the back, in the biceps, pushes, working your chest and triceps. Round five. Still gonna feel it. 10 dips. Five sets down. A little over 5 minutes in, about almost the aim on basically. Again, you gotta scale down the reps, scale down the reps, whether that's something like 3x7x10 or even 3x5x10. Even less than that, just stay consistent. If you can't stick for 20 minutes, go down to 15 minutes, go down to 12 minutes, go down to 10 minutes, whatever you got. Round number 6 coming up. Sometimes you hear athletes say, calisthenic athletes say, oh, this was easy, that was easy. None of this is ever easy. You gotta work for your reps. No matter what shape you're in, no matter how many years you got under your belt, a pull-up is never easy. Dips and push-ups, know. They're not easy. If it was easy, everybody would be doing it. 6 rounds in. Round number 7. About 8 minutes in, go to low. Make sure your chest is touching the floor, full range of motion. When you do pull-ups, you're gonna go like this, right? Those competition reps. Same thing with push-ups. See a lot of athletes go this way. Make sure your chest touches the floor. Make sure you lock out those elbows at the top. Working full range of motion recruits more muscle fibers. There's benefits to shorties. Right, but when you're training for competition, you're just training to get strong overall. Full range of motion for all reps. Pull-ups, dips, push-ups, squats, muscle-ups, all that. And we're at the halfway point, 7 rounds in, 8 coming up. 10 minutes down, 10 minutes to go. Leg. And now we're staying a little deep. Pull the thing back. Max fill the push-ups. And all the movements. That looks nice. Make sure I'm extended. I'm not doing any of this, which might be done inadvertently without you even realizing you're not bending the elbows or extending the elbows. This is why quad reps are beneficial too. Stopping at the bottom of reps, death stop reps. Do that a lot in Europe, competitions. 10 dips. Alright, 15 push-ups. Make sure for the last pull-up, you come down to the bottom. Don't jump down from the top. Pull up to this. Right? Not this. 10 dips. Push-ups. Feel my chest. Got that blood going right now. Got that pump. That's good. Got about 6 minutes left. I've done this before. At this pace, I'm not gonna beat my best score, but right now I'm not in competition shape. But I'm working to get in competition shape. The competition next month, the 7th, the Boogie Down, the Bronx, hometown, and then there's a big one in Jersey, in January. I'm gonna video both. You already know your boy's gonna be in it. Taking the double. $700 cash for that Jersey comp. 15 push-ups. Break this up and get more rounds, but that's not my goal, that's not my focus. I want to stay on the bar, I want to stay on the bars, I want to stay on the floor and get my reps in, finish my reps, finish my set. It's going to have better carryover to what it is I'm working. Five pulls. pump, chest and triceps, simple pump. Push-ups, so as many rounds as you can get, many sets in 20 minutes. We got 15 rounds plus 5 reps. Again, that is not my best, but I'm gearing up now for competition, so that's gonna go up substantially. As the conditioning goes up, the muscular endurance goes up, right? Muscle memory, all that good stuff. Follow me on the gram, FitnessFeed21. Make sure you guys like and subscribe, share this with a friend, share this on your platforms. You guys see the shirt, girl dad. Shout out to my daughter, Liana. Papi loves you. Let's get it.